Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to another episode of Making It in Holland. Today, I have a bit of a special reaction video. We're going to be watching together one of the more popular videos of the channel, Not Just Bikes, entitled Why Dutch Bikes Are Better and Why You Should Get One. I'm very curious, so let's go ahead and dive into it.
This is our Dutch bicycle. It's an Omofiets, literally grandma bicycle. There is really nothing special about it, at least here in the Netherlands.
All right, I have to stop it right here because what you see is a very, very typical Dutch bike. This is probably one of the most popular models you're going to be seeing around when you're wandering Amsterdam, Rotterdam, pretty much every single big as well as small Dutch city. One thing that I never understood about this bike is that it's called Omofiets. Grandma feet.
And there's nothing grandma about this bike.
Mainly because there are no handbrakes. If you want to stop the bike, you have to be cycling backwards. But it takes quite a bit of practice to understand exactly how much pressure you need to be putting on the back wheel so that when you're stopping, you don't have this like jolting effect. So I don't know why they call it grandma feet. In my opinion, this kind of braking is actually quite a little bit of an advanced technique. I for myself prefer bikes that have handle brakes. I just find them a lot more easier to navigate. All right, let's continue.
In most other countries, bicycles are used primarily for sport and exercise.
That's true. For example, I'm from Turkey and you don't really use bikes as a way to transport from one place to another, mainly because there is not really a thorough bike structure that's really going to help you to bike with ease without getting stuck in traffic or, God forbid, have horrible accidents. One thing I have to disagree here with what he says is, I actually do find a lot of Dutch people, after they're done with using their bike as a way of transport, they actually take out their more advanced bikes and they use it for exercise as well.
Riding this way lets you wear any type of clothing you'd like because it's no different than sitting in a chair.
Okay, I gotta stop it here because he said something really interesting that riding a bike like this, it's almost like sitting in a chair and you can pretty much wear whatever you like. I definitely disagree. I do know a lot of these bikes do come with things like chain protectors and certain ways to make sure that your clothing doesn't get tangled up in the wheel, but a lot of Dutch people that I know, they don't actually wear whatever they're gonna wear while they're biking. And especially this applies to things like long dresses, long skirts, as well as long coats, especially if they're long and relatively thin and they sort of wave in the air, which means the likelihood of it getting stuck in the wheel is a lot higher. And another thing that no one I know really does is bike around wearing uncomfortable shoes. In the case of women, I really rarely see anyone biking around in heels. So I do have to disagree a little bit here. Yes, these bikes are very ergonomically designed. They're very ergonomic. That's the word. And they're very comfortable, but that doesn't mean you can wear whatever the heck you want while you're cycling, especially if you don't have a lot of biking practice or experience. Like if you're coming from a country where biking was only a support, like you just do it for exercise, and then you come to a country where it's like a mode of transport, meaning there are rules and that you have to follow. And, you know, Dutch bikers, they're not really slow. So you're expected to sort of upkeep with that rhythm. I would not recommend you to wear whatever the heck you want. All right, let's continue.
This thing here is called a frame lock, and almost every bicycle in the Netherlands has one. These are incredibly convenient for so many reasons, but I've almost never seen them outside of the Netherlands, Denmark, and Japan. They are an easy way to lock the back wheel of your bicycle for quick stops, which makes it really, really easy to pop into a shop when riding somewhere.
And that's also the best way to get your bike in the Netherlands stolen. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're thinking about purchasing a bike here, or if you already have a bike, you know exactly what I'm talking about. You cannot just rely on these locks that come with the bike, because essentially you can lift the back wheel and then the front wheel is free, so you could literally easily carry the bike over, roll it, and then steal it. Drop me down in the comment box if you ever got your bike stolen here, because this is a very common story that I've been hearing from a lot of people who say that, oh, I have a lock on my bike, therefore I don't need to get another one. But it is something that I highly recommend you get to protect your bike, is investing in a proper chain lock that you can double protect your bike with. Even if you're going to the supermarket and you're going to be parking your bike only for a couple of minutes, people who are gonna wanna steal your bike, they don't care if you just went out for a couple of minutes. If they want it, they will take your bike.
If you see bikes locked only like this, it's probably because the owner considers their bike too crappy to steal.
What's that saying? One man's rubbish is another man's gold. This is exactly why you should be protecting your bike, even if you think it's a crappy bike, at all costs.
These bikes are not built for speed, they're built to last.
And that's a fact. I have my bike from this Dutch brand called Batavus since 2005, and it's still in a very fantastic condition. I've parked it indoors, I've parked it outside, under very harsh Dutch weather conditions. The painting is still perfect, the coating is still perfect. Over the years, I did have to get a few things changed, like the side fenders, as well as some of the smaller accessories. I had to get the brakes done at least one time during that period too. But if you consider it from 2005, end of 2021, I'm filming this, I've had this bike for good 16 years, and I can see myself using it for at least another couple of years.
Another thing you'll sometimes see on bicycles here is a dynamo. These go in the wheel hub or on the wheel and generate enough electricity to power LED lights. These are pretty nice, as you never need to worry about recharging batteries or forgetting your lights. Just another small thing that makes these bicycles simple for everyday use.
This just reminded me I do need to get my dynamo replaced. Now, my bike is obviously several years old at this point, and in the design, the dynamo is relatively bulky, which means it kind of sticks out next to the wheel. And those of you who are familiar, or those of you who don't know, the Dutch bike parking spaces are very narrow. So if you have two bikes and you need to put your bike in between, it's going to hit and it's going to potentially get damaged. And I did have a perfectly functioning dynamo until about 3-4 years ago. The other bikers pretty much destroyed my dynamo. This makes me really sad. So these days when I do ride my bike, I'm actually technically doing something illegal. I am riding without lights, and if actually the traffic police or the police in general stop me on the street, I am pretty sure I could get in trouble for not having functioning lights. So I definitely do recommend, if you don't have any lights on your bike, A, to get some, and B, if you are thinking about purchasing a bike, definitely a good idea to get a bike with a dynamo, so you don't always have to think about charging the batteries.
One group in Winnipeg, Canada, got so frustrated trying to find practical urban bicycles that they started importing new and used bicycles from the Netherlands. They call themselves the Plain Bicycle Project, and they're regularly receiving shipping containers full of bicycles from the Netherlands.
I bet a lot of these bikes that go to this company in Canada come from Dutch bike cemeteries. Now, this is a real phenomenon. Dutch bike cemeteries are where your bikes get taken to after you've abandoned the bike. So if your bike is broken or something is wrong with it, people just kind of leave it somewhere out there in a bike park or somewhere randomly out in the streets. And this also happens to the bikes that are in perfectly good condition, but they're parked illegally. How do I know this in so much detail? I had not just one, but in fact, two of my bikes get taken to a Dutch bike cemetery because I illegally parked my bikes and I didn't go to get them on time. So how it went was, I left my bikes in the central station of Rotterdam. There's this gorgeous garage downstairs. I didn't know that when you park your bike, it takes note of the time and the hour you put your bike there. And if you actually go over that certain amount, through the computer, people working there know that this bike has been abandoned. So they call the bike cemetery people and your bike comes and gets removed. And in fact, I had some pretty pricey chains that I tied my bikes with. And these people came, they cut the chains, they were like 80 euros each, and they brought the bikes to the bike cemetery. And I, of course, panicked. And these cemeteries, they tend to be sort of like off the beaten track. So I had to take like a random train to kind of middle of nowhere and walk a little bit. And then you end up in this kind of vast concrete field with just thousands and thousands of bikes. So what happens if you don't go to pick up your bike afterwards is, I guess it goes to places like Canada, where they get refurbished and they get resold to the people as functioning, sturdy Dutch bikes. Or I'm guessing some people who are in the secondhand bike business, they go there to purchase these bikes. Maybe they even get them for free of charge and then do some upgrades, whatnot, and sell it to other people. I had two of my bikes there, but I'm only just one person. So when I went to pick up my bike, I picked my favorite one, the one that I've had since 2005, and I had another bike actually that my dad had bought me not that long ago, and I was going to come and pick that one up a couple of days later, and I told to the people at the reception that I am going to be coming to write my number down because I didn't want my bike to disappear. When I came back a couple of days later, they told me sorry, but we sent your bike away. With that said, I hope you enjoyed my reaction video. Let me know if you want to see more videos like this by letting me know what you thought about this one down in the comments. And as usual, until the next time, don't forget to stay awesome. Bye bye.